Hello, Alessia.
Hello, Undine.
Hello, everyone. How are you doing?
I'm good.
So, what do we talk about today?
I guess we should talk about the cervical section of our spine.
Okay, so yeah. The neck, and I like to talk about the head a little bit with the neck. So it's, can we see it at all? It's this part right here at the top. The neck and the head is, so those vertebrae here, there are 7 of them. Don't write it out, that was a test. The most prominent one, so the base of your cervical is very easy to find. It's the most prominent. Can you turn around maybe?
Yeah, but I have my ponytail.
So it's the most prominent vertebrae that you can find here at the base of your skull. Very easy to spot and very easy to find. That is your bottom cervical. So it's an easy way to find the transition between the cervical and the thoracic. And as we mentioned before, the transition part are the most vulnerable. So it's very important for you to know where they locate so that you can lengthen your spine and lessen those transition. Your cervicals are, from all of the spine, the most mobile area. And the reason being, it's the one that has the, you know, the lateral processes here and the back processes. They are the shortest and the smallest of all of the vertebrae, which allows then the vertebrae on top of each other to kind of move sideways and back because there is nothing stopping them from moving. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Does make sense.
Well, yeah.
So what that means is, of all your spine, your neck can do more than the others with less restriction. The interesting part for a dancer in the cervical, I think, are the top two cervical. They are quite unique because their shape is completely different from all of the others.